Hi, and welcome back to our Open Stop Motion film project. I have been sick in a week, and then I had some technical issues yesterday, and I thought I could get some hardware and fix them, but that didn't end like I wanted it to. So, because tonight we had our first kids workshop, I'll be sending every Monday an hour before this or 2 hours before this. But I managed to mess up the whole caboodle tonight. So let us see how this will go. I forgot to record, and I used the wrong camera, and so on and so on. But let's see how it goes with this. That's life is a dangerous stuff. Last time we ended here with this hand, and we have to do this finish. And then, have to finish this, and we have been, and I have been printing a lot of trees, and I still need a lot more, so that's kind of just working day and night, so. But this are not working if I don't do anything to it. So that's what we will do tonight. See if we can get it a little more like we want. And we have made some new time schedule. From now on it will be from 8 p.m. to 12 p.m. My time plus one UTC Copenhagen time. So that's because I wanted to do this kid stuff, and there's also other things I want to, but we will come to that later on. But this stuff we have to do, and it's the thing I use the most time on, that's to make this stop motion, and both now on and in the future. So this hand is still a little rough, so we need to make it a little more lifelike. If we can, are gonna use it. And we are. But the problem is when I was sick, and the problem is when I get sick, everything is standing still, so, and there's nobody here but me, so, that's what can happen. I usually don't get sick, but sometimes, and this time was a nasty one. It's time to disappear again. But now you're fit for fight. So I have to get back in after the usual game, the usual routine. And that, I think, was what happened tonight with the kids' workshop. There are so many things you have to remember. And just when I started, I usually have a monitor in the workshop, and I still have, but I couldn't get that to work for some reason, I don't know why. I should be able to have four monitors on, and when I couldn't get the fourth to work, so then I had to use, I have this, what is it called, Team Viewer. But to use that, you have to be on another net. So I've used a mobile dongle I have, so I can put in the computer my laptop, so when I'm out traveling, I can get on the net. But you know, the picture quality on that is not that good. But that was the only way I could get a monitor in, so I could see so I could change the cameras, and then I changed it wrong. And forgot everything else, because 5 minutes before got on, I got that problem, so you know how it is. When things start to go wrong, it's going really wrong. And that was how we started the night. And remember the light and whatnot. Thank you. this here. Broadcasting on a pocket money budget, that's kind of right on the edge. Is possible. And I also have had in the week, I have a couple of net failures where the net provider have updated some stuff on the net, on the servers or what, and they don't tell it up front. You just see that you are down, and then you have to figure out why. And you always reckon that it's yourself and your own system that's gone haywire, but it wasn't. Be nice of them if they just send a mail in advance that now we are gonna close whole thing down. Because they have no problem doing that when they have been in my bank account and drawn money. Then they have no problem telling me what they have done. So one should think that they could do the same the other way around. But no. They don't think that's necessary. How do we do that? Now tomorrow I have to make the first hour of tonight. I have to redo that. And that was not the plan. I want to upload it to the site. We were making What is it they are saying? It takes 10,000 hours to get really good at stuff, so eat shit in my lifetime. But I will do my best, my best. And I should have gotten a lot of plastic today also, but I didn't get it. Now they say it comes tomorrow. Come from southern Germany, so and it's sent with UPS, so and they can never find the address. Oh yes, they find the address, but then there is a door phone. But they never press it, they just stand in front of the door, cannot see it, and then they drive again. Everybody else can, not those. And it's not because the door phone is hidden. It isn't. Even drunk people in the night, jokers, find it very amusing to use it sometimes. And I sit here in the late hours. Maybe we should give the UPS man a ring or two so he can figure it out. Maybe that will help. Maybe we should take our oil again.
paper towel.
Now it's gotten colder in here than you remember all the summer. The clay was so soft that it was nearly impossible to work with. Cold. So can't get it all. And I haven't turned up the heat in the studio because with all these lamps it gets very hot very fast. I have 4 big softboxes on, so you can imagine. Another one. Okay, yeah. Thank you. Overdo it a little, but not too much, because we lose a lot in the print and scan. Kind of in the olden days, then I retouched pictures for newspapers and brochures and advertising and that kind of stuff, and in not in Photoshop but on the old fashioned way with brush and colors more black and white and gray tones, because there were not always that many colors. But when you had to print something, and at that time when you had to print something, a picture in a newspaper, you have to heavily retouch it, because otherwise you couldn't see what it was. It was very crude kind of printing technique. So the stencils was very rough. It was not like today. And that was kind of an art to know exactly how much to give it, so it didn't look kind of drawn, overdone, but enough so it was, you could see what it was and still look naturally. That was not that easy, but over time you got the feel of it. Kind of a like a chef when he spice up the food. Not too much, not too little. And the same is in business. Too much salt and pepper, chili. Something here we don't want to have. should have taken the other camera in here, but I didn't. Most of them is in the workshop and looking at nothing. And figures or whatnot. This one is very thick here. Thank you. smoothen it out when we are finished. Soon I have 75 trees. Sorry. But I can see now that I have to use at least twice as much. It's easier to see when they are standing on the table than you can. You cannot see them now, but you can see them, some of them over by the brushes here, over in the corner here. You can see the top of them over there. There's a lot of them now. But we need many, many more. Give him some nails so he can scratch his hair. Thank you. I think. I have to lift the camera up a little so you can see. But I always do this because of the legs is in the way. But so that you not get seasick, you can look at this as long. While I'm doing it, back. Boat. So. Now you can see a little better what I'm doing. Problem. I have to make a depth try. Okay, I can do it. I wasn't sure. manicure. Isn't that the word for it? Or what? Nail polish. Fiddly, fiddly. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh.
Again, I have to be careful not to use my own old hand too much as a model, because he's a young kid, so. Totally overboard. This one.
Thank you.
I think I will take on a visit the bathroom and take a rest on, so
it's cold.
And then some more coffee. We need coffee and a lot of it. Draft around my back where I sit. It's an old building, so not that tight. As new buildings are first, when you start to use another language, you are very careful to pronounce things right. But after a while, you start to be a little careless. And eat the half of the word yourself. I guess I can be difficult enough to understand in the first place. if you all were speaking Danish, it would be so much easier for me. But I guess that's not gonna happen anytime soon. People that talk that language. So I guess it's me that has to talk yours. Least one we all can agree upon. We only had a few years with English in my school time, so not like my grandchildren, they have it in the school for nearly first class. So they will be good at it when they grow up. They already use a lot of English slang. It's kind of funny to hear when my grandson comes down to me. He always asks if he can come so he can join, and his uncle and play Minecraft with him. Then they use Skype to do that. So they can talk together, and then they play over the net. I know English talking people maybe not think it sounds fun, but it does when a Danish kid in his age talk about joining all the time. this is fancy. Sometime when I read him night stories, then all the a lot of Star Wars figures in some of his Lego stories and whatnot, and he correct me all the time. I'm not pronouncing them right. He is an expert. He can curl his tongue like nobody else when he say some of the names. It's really fun to hear. He is a sweetheart. Best buddies. Especially when I bring him some new Legos. It helps a lot. He's the kid I know that have most of that stuff. His room are full of it. But he still loves it. And gets equally happy every time he gets a new fancy machine or what. Lego was Thomas the Train. And he had every single train. Also started to go to his room and play loud music. is only, what is he, 8, but he loves to go down there and play. Oh, here, audiobooks. I can't forget I messed up the kids workshop tonight. But I did. That really nags me. When things go like that. And I did exactly the same when I started to do this. The first many times I forgot something, or yeah, I still do, but not that often anymore. Every time it's new stuff. To see if I can't make it good again. then I have to figure out why I cannot get my... one monitor to work. That I cannot understand. First I was afraid that it was because of a long cable, signal cable, but it wasn't. The computer will simply not see it. Must be some graphical driver issue. And that's something you have when you press the limit all the times, like I do. The best one would have been if all the screens was HDMI and exactly the same, but I have two Acers and two HP and whatnot. They are different, all of them. I don't have the money to go and buy four screen at the time, and I have to buy a lot of other things too. I want to have a backup computer. I don't have that. If this goes down, then I am off until I get it fixed. And sometimes that can take up till 7 days when it really start to play with you. That is sometimes has a tendency. It's not always easy to figure out what's wrong. Thank you. even when you have worked with computers that many years I have, it still can be a challenge. Sometimes. Last time there was something serious wrong was that the it was a system hard drive that was tired. One of those errors where it only happens once in a while. Google Plus message. I have set the timer on because I hope that I will be able to when we only record 4 hours, then I will hopefully be able to upload medium the recording to on my side. I of course have it on the hard drive, but all the other ones we have made, but and we have really made many. We have made around 70 now, so 6 hours long. So you can imagine. It goes fast. And the music is playing. Hope we will get a lot done here in this fall and winter. Get a little bit closer every day. So sooner or later we will get there. Isn't that clever people say that it's not the goal but the journey that's a good thing. Certainly have a lot of journey in front of us. There will not be be any lag on that. Up in the branches now. So we can cook one more tonight. That's a good thing. And we get 4 more rolls of plastic tomorrow. Should be to a lot of trees. At least 2 months of printing. At least. I think only I use about 1 roll in a month when it drives 24/7. And this time I should get some better plastic. But also much more expensive, but then you see how good that is. Because I certainly have had a lot of trouble with this kind I'm using now. That have been a pain in the behind. The problem is that the variation in the temperature is very big on it. Right now the extruder is 260 degrees hot Celsius, and normally it only have to be 230 degrees. And sometimes it does work with 30 degrees, but then some part of the plastic have a higher temperature, melting temperature. And that's in the same role. So quality is very ununiform. And the plastic I get now is the only plastic you can, at least I've been able to find, that comes with a temperature chart, because the temperature, melting temperature, is different in different colors. Why, I don't know. It is. And the problem is that there is a step motor that's drives the plastic down through the extruder, and I'm afraid I'm destroying that if it cannot get with this cheap plastic, when it cannot get it through. If it don't melt, then it kind of just stands there and turn around and eating into the plastic without anything coming out of the extruder. And that way the motor gets very hot. And overburdened, I think. electronics and heat don't match that, got that good together. That often ends very bad. I know that laptops and stuff runs very hot nowadays because, but it is not a good thing. In the long run, it isn't. Even they say they are made for it. I think this one is starting to be a little dry. Oop. Thank you. by the way, last time we talked about it, was it could be a good thing if I just make one hand and then mirror it. And last yesterday or the day before, I updated the software to the printer, and now it can mirror. So that was a good thing. Two hands, 2 feet, because after this we have to make some feet. We have to save where we can. So that there can be some more plastic and clay and stuff, computers and monitors, cameras, mics and lights, carts and whatnot. Tons of stuff. We can use all the money we can get our hands on, and then some. A bigger studio too, because this is very grand as it is. Google have decided that this here is a porn site, so I cannot get any AdSense account. And everyone in the world beside Google knows that this is not true, but they have an old perverted crawler in that sense, so it keeps finding an old sites that try to make money on links a long time ago, but I had nothing to do with that. It was long before I bought the domain. The site is from 2006, and I bought the domain in 2011. And I did nothing of checking out what had been on the domain before, because I thought this never had been used before. I just typed in the name on my domain provider, and it was available. Those of you who have tried to find names, you know it's kind of difficult to find good names. You have to come up with a lot of suggestions, and there are a lot of firms that have bought all the obvious ones and just have them. They are not using them, they are just having them. So that when we want to use them, then they hope we will come and buy them of them, and they can earn a lot of money on it. So I was happy when I at last found a name that has something to do with what I'm doing. So I didn't check in and I even didn't know where to check, even if I have wanted to. But there is a site, I don't remember what its name is, so if you ever get a domain, be wise to figure out if Google have banned it. So it's not enough that it is available, it also has to be Google-proofed, because if you are not on Google, you are nowhere. You are dead. None exist. I don't care that much, because I will do this regardless of anything, even if I to sit here and do it for myself. But it is more fun when there are others that think it's fun too. But it is kind of lonely anyway. applied several times, but it still comes up and say it's but it's fun. I'm sending the site. What you see here is what you see on my site, so there is no difference. But a lot of stuff from my site, a lot of episodes, but video episode is on the net, and they have no problem putting advertisement on those. It's okay, but it don't help me much, because not that I have not enough viewers to show it. You have to have tons of viewers to get paid anything for that. But even if I had, I will not get paid, because I cannot get an AdSense account, so they are on a freebie. They are okay with advertising, but they are not okay with paying. So that's kind of fun. But what do we care? Because that is a very important thing. Not plural. We only got one nail fixed, I think. We need some more, but I need to visit the baby. So you keep an eye on this one, and you see, very soon it's finished, so we can put a new one in. Is it ready? Yeah, but it has to cool a little before I can take it off. right now it's kind of glued to the bed. But the latest print I have gotten out is really nice, so that's a good thing. I can take one you can see. Down. I will try. It has to heat up again so we can follow that here. Got to put the mic on this one, but you can see in the bottom of the picture a stand extruder $185 and the bed $55. So the bed is hot enough now because I only have it to $55. what you can see in the or on the right side, you can see the blue, green, yellow and red in the bottom, and it's set to 260 degrees. That's it, the extruder temperature, the lowest one of them. And you can see the little arrow that are in the yellow now is working its way up to the red one, and when up to the one, it's stationary up there. And when it reached that one, you're ready to roll. You can see it goes reasonably quick. You're already up on 223 degrees. The default printing temperature normally is 230 degrees. But this one need a lot more heat to work. Thirty degrees more. And that I get tomorrow. It only needs 197 degrees to print, according to their own charts. So it can melt nearly 60 or more than 60 degrees under what this can. So that's we are looking forward to. And they have temperature charts on all their colors. And where this one, these one have no temperature charts at all. So now we up there, 260. Has to drive down to where it has to start. And then I first have to put some plastic to the extruder because it had lost some while it was heating up. so that the extruder are filled up. Wrong way.
Aye.
Idiot.
Pulled it out instead of pushing it through. So
but it should work fine now. Thank you.
keeping a little eye on it while it starts. It's always the critical point. It's when it starts up. Well, I think it is. It is driving. But even with this temperature, this plastic are not melting right. It's a funny thing. And that's how it is. Melts very uneven. But that's how it is. I'm really looking forward to the new plastic. This plastic cost, let's see, it's there, oh, wrong, I cannot. There it is. 2. This
plastic here costs about $30 a roll, and the new one cost about $50 a roll. So there is a price difference.
And we hope it worth it, because I don't know yet.
There are not many that
put so much plastic through that I do, so it's difficult to find people on the net who really have a lot of experience with the plastic. They all always only talk about printers. And they are pretty much the same, all of them. So
those that sells plastic, they all say that theirs is the best. And they cannot be true, all of them. So it's kind of trial and error. first plastic. I didn't buy it because it was cheap. I bought it because it was a Danish supplier, so it was easier for me in that way. In a that then get it from the southern Germany. I can take the phone and talk to the guy and so on, you know how it is. My German is a little rusty, so I have not used German for years. So. And then he used Danish mail service, and that's better than UPS. I'm telling you. They have no problem finding the address and use the door phone. Because if we don't have the door closed, I live in the inner city, and if we don't have the door closed, then all the drunks are doing unnamely things in the inside. So you won't have that. So for people to get in, they have to use the door phone, and then I have to push a button so they can open the door. Every time I have gotten something with you, UPS, I had it's always taken an extra couple of days because they one day they come to the door. And the next day they come with the package. And then I have to phone them and say, use the door. They themselves don't have have phones, so they cannot DHL. When they can come, they always phone me and say, "We have a package for you." And then
I live, the studio is on the second floor, so I go down to them and then I don't have to run up the stairs, and everything goes smoothly and easier. Much easier. They are happy and I am happy. One thing I also think that's wrong, that is, it's always new people, and the reason is that it's a very low paid job. They can barely earn a living on it, and I have heard and read on the net that many what are that called? I don't know what it's called. What is that called? Trucking companies, they are driving for them. They are saying they will not drive for them anymore because they cannot. Earn money at it. So. It's a very hard competition. Few years back, there were only Danish postal service, but since we have joined EU, it has to get out licitation, so everyone can bid on it. So we have UPS and DHL and the Norwegian Postal Service, and I don't. There are so many. And they are changing. It's never the same driver that comes twice. Because they get fed up of it. And they also have another problem. Many of them is not from this country, so it must be hard for them to find their way around and some of them cannot speak the language, so I guess they cannot read the language either, so I don't know how they manage to do it. But and they don't speak English either, and they don't speak German. I have really tried to talk to some of them, but it's not easy. So they are nice people, but I think they have got a job that they cannot just trying to live make a living, sorry. Can't be tough in that business. If you have to get to a ton of places during a day and you have problem finding your way around, then it's not that easy. Cannot blame them. see it from one angle, then it's good enough. On another, it isn't. To be careful with the nail root. Whoops, that was not good enough. Because they can be really sore. So, sorry about that.
Kind of working in another direction. They are good at outer loops, but they are not good at inner loops, if that makes any sense. Hope it does.
To fiddle a little more with this, but we are not going to get any further tonight. We can see that this one is trying to make us a new tree, and we are at midnight here, and we have to close for today, and tomorrow we will finish this one and start on a foot. But until then, good night here from Denmark, and have a pleasant day or evening and wherever you are in the world. Hope I see you again tomorrow. Goodbye.